ما هي بغي يعني. Then the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he turned around, he said that he is the best teacher. He never hit me, nor did he harm me, nor did he insult me. But rather, all he said to me is, إن هذه الصلاة لا يصلح فيها شيء من كلام الناس. Indeed, this is the prayer. Nothing from the speech of people is allowed in it. Except, طبعا, we know from the sunnah, except in the sujood, you can make dua from your own self, يعني, in Arabic. And before the taslim, Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah mentioned. But إن هذه الصلاة لا يصلح فيها شيء من كلام الناس. إنها تسبيح وتكبير وقراءة القرآن. That this prayer shouldn't mention anything from the kalam of the speech of people. Rather, it is tasbih, it is takbir, and it is qira'at al-Qur'an. Three things is this prayer. Then he asked him some other aspects of ignorance that he was ignorant of. And then the Messenger of Allah explained to him. And towards the end of the hadith, he says, I had a jariya, a slave girl, and she was looking after my sheep, and one of the sheep got eaten by a wolf. And I slapped her because I'm a man from the children of Adam. Meaning he became angry and he slapped her on her face. And then the Messenger of Allah said, bring her. Because he said, shall I free her? He said, no, first bring her. Then when he brought her, then the Messenger of Allah said, who am I? He said, you are the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Messenger of Allah. He said, where is Allah? Ayn Allah? He said, fis sama. She said, fis sama. And fi in Arabic has meaning of ala as well. As Allah says in the Quran, wamshu fil ardi, and go in the land. Doesn't mean inside the land, means over the land. So this hadith, then the Messenger says, from this he said, i'tiqha fa innaha mu'mina. Free her as she is a believer. She's a believer, so free her. And he made the aspect of belief the answer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above. Ar-Rahmanu ala al-arshi istawa. So from this, he said this to Ali Hilwa. He said, what about this hadith? So Ali al-Hilwa, being smart and being from amongst those intelligent يعني, people that you find nowadays, who try to put their aql in front of the text, in front of the kalam of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, she's ignorant. She said that, she answered that he's above, but she's ignorant. هي جاهلة, كانت جاهلة. Then Shaykh Muhammad al-Banna, جزاه الله خير, and you see from his argument, he said, did the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam come to change the ignorance of the people or came to accept it? He came to change. And he said, as if I put a bucket of water over his head. And then afterwards, some of the people started screaming and shouting. This is, Jama'at, he's from the Jama'at of Ansar al-Sunnah, who were the Salafi Jama'at at that time, pushing forward the Aqeedah of Ahl al-Sunnah, Ahl al-Hadith, the Salaf al-Salih, correct Aqeedah. He said, your Jama'at Ansar al-Sunnah. Your Jama'at Ansar al-Sunnah. Jama'at of Hamid Faqi, who used to be who in charge of the Jama'at there in Egypt, in Qahira. Jama'at Hamid Faqi. And this is the first time he heard these Jama'at, these names. So he said, that night I didn't sleep. Just thinking about it. Who is Hamid Faqi? Who is Ansar al-Sunnah? What is this? So the next morning, he met up with his companion that he always talks with, Muhammad al-Arnous. And he discussed with him. He said, this is what happened last night. And then he said, if you can... then he knew, he heard about this Sheikh Hamid Faqi, rahimahullah. And then later on, they managed to get to know the Ahl al-Ilm at that time. And he said, I stayed with them. I met Sheikh Abdurrazzaq al-Afifi, who was the deputy of the Mufti, Sheikh bin Baz, rahimahullah, before they passed away. So he was a alim, Sheikh Abdurrazzaq al-Afifi, rahimahullah. And also with them in Cairo was Sheikh Muhammad Khalil al-Harras, the explainer of Aqidah al-Wasitiyya, which is translated into English. And also with them, tab'an, was Sheikh Hamid Faqi, the Ra'is of Ansar al-Sunnah, who taught some of the mashayikh that you know nowadays in the Mamlaka, like Sheikh Saleh al-Sheikh. I remember going to a lecture many years back in Jeddah, where he gave a lecture there, and he said, my Sheikh, Sheikh Hamid Faqi. So this silsila that you find amongst the scholars, this chain of taking from those who are older than them, you always find it in the manhaj or the tariq of Ahl Sunnah. So he said, I stayed with them until I became amongst them, you know, giving da'wah. And then he said, when they opened, the, then he said, يعني he stayed in Egypt giving da'wah with Ansar al-Sunnah. He mentioned one trip that he went to, because in that time there was a lot of Sufis. He said they went to one masjid with, he was with Muhammad Muhammad Arnous, who also followed them in the da'wah. And just as a side benefit as well, the companion of the bookshop that he met first of all, who was also upon the Salafi manhaj, the way of the scholars then, the Ahl al-Sunnah, he said even that person, he was a knowledgeable person. And Qadr Allah in Jeddah, I managed to find a book, Sharh Usul al-Thalatha, by this companion of this bookshop, the owner of the other, became so happy. And I showed the Sheikh. He says, oh, my Sheikh. He was so happy to see his name. And in this Sharh of Usul al-Thalatha, also you find that in one of the footnotes, he says, I have also explained Umdat al-Ahkam and Bulugh al-Maram in such and such book, and Kitab al-Tawheed. So you can see the kind of books they are looking at, the books they are reviving, or the books they are trying to make accessible to the Ummah. The books of Ahl al-Sunnah, Bulugh al-Maram, we know by Ibn Hajar, is an excellent book of hadith describing different aspects of worship. And also Umdat al-Ahkam by Abdul Ghani al-Maqdisi, and also Kitab al-Tawheed, one of the best books you find on Tawheed, discussing the various aspects of Tawheed. So anyway, he was with them in this jama'ah. And then later on, he says, I got a call when they opened up the ma'had in Riyadh, and Sheikh Abdul Razak Afifi has gone to Riyadh already, and he was with Sheikh Ibn Baz rahimullah, and Sheikh Muhammad Ibn Ibrahim was there, and Sheikh Abdurrahman al-Sa'di. These are old names, yani these are names that are in a different era, it's like a different time zone, but subhanallah, it's just like yesterday, because we see their books. Sheikh Abdurrahman al-Sa'di, he left a tafsir book, Taysir Aziz al-Rahman. Sheikh Muhammad Ibrahim also left some beneficial books as well. He said while he's there in Egypt, he also, in the early stage of being with the Jama'at Ansar al-Sunnah, he saw Hassan al-Banna. And they are not related, if the people think they are related, not in Nasab nor in Manhaj. So when he saw Hassan al-Banna, he saw him giving a lecture. And there was some of Sheikh Muhammad al-Wahhab Marzuq al-Banna's close friends, and they would listen, and he's trying to advise them that this person, you know. And one time he was in a lecture, and Hassan al-Banna gave a sharh of the hadith of the man who prayed badly. The hadith, which is authentic, the man who gave to salam to the Rasul, he said, go back and pray, you have not prayed. That hadith. So he's given, and Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna, Zala Khair, he said that the sharh was a good sharh. But then what happened was worse. What happened afterward was worse. Because when the prayer time came, a big Sufi sheikh came along, and Hassan al-Banna said to him, you lead the prayer. So he got him to the prayer, and he prayed so quick, just like the, you know, what do you call it? The pigeon, or the pecking of a bird. The hadith mentions, I think, a pigeon or... But anyway, he pecked so quick in the prayer. And he said... Sheikh Muhammad ibn Ali said, as if he misunderstood the hadith. He's the one who prayed badly, he got praise for what he was doing. He misunderstood the hadith totally. But you know, bad habits die hard. Allahumma stand. So he prayed, and he went to Hassan ibn Ali, said to him, your Sheikh, as though he misunderstood the hadith, why don't you advise him? And Hassan ibn Ali just changed the subject. Moved him away from the topic of advising this person. And from then on, you know, Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna, Zala Khair, he said, now I know this person, you know, he's misguiding the people, he's not correcting the people. And also there was Sayyid Sabiq at that time, who left Fiqh al-Sunnah. He met him, Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna met Sayyid Sabiq, and he asked him, you know, he said, look, they were discussing Hassan al-Banna at the time. They said, look, you know, he doesn't correct this. And then Sayyid Sabiq mentioned to him a similar incident. He said, one time we were in a qariya, and there were people worshipping inside a masjid with graves, and people worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said to Hassan al-Banna, correct the people,